Hi friends, welcome back to today's lectures. This is Hadil Mustafa. Let us continue with CMA Foundation Economics lecture. In the previous lecture, we have discussed about the central bank. Now we are going for the financial institution. See, financial institutions are also a form of organization who are dealing with the money. It is not just the banking system, but there are also other financial institutions which are also involved in those activities. But the problem is that it is not completely a banking system. There are some restrictions, there are some differences with the banks. Okay, so let us see what are the financial institutions and what they do. Okay, so let's start. Financial institution. First financial institution that we are going to know is Industrial Finance Corporation of India, IFC. It is established in 1948. Established in 1st July 1948. What is their main object? To make medium and large scale credit to the industrial units. See, giving credit, giving loan is an activity of bank. But here, the Industrial Finance Corporation of India, IFC, is giving medium and large long-term credit to industrial units. This is for industrial units only, for industrial organizations. This financial institution is giving loan. Okay, so that is their function. Now let us know that is their main objective. Now let us know the functions of the financial institution. Granting loans and advances for a period of 25 years. See, these all are given for the industrial units. Okay, then subscribing to shares and debentures floated by the industrial concern. That is purchasing shares and debentures of these industrial concerns. That is also their function. Next one is granting loan in the foreign currencies. Sometimes they can give the foreign currency loans because they have, when the industries are having some dealings with outside the India, then they may need foreign currencies also. So this can also be given by these institutions. Then next one is guaranteeing for deferred payments. See, deferred payment we have already discussed in the chapter of money. There we have discussed. Here the institute can give guarantee to this deferred payment in respect of import of capital goods. If they want to import any capital goods, if these industries have to get some capital goods outside the country, then this institute can give guarantee for those. Now, State Finance Corporation, SFC. So let us see what are their points to be noted. Established in 1953 in Punjab. Okay. At present, there are 18 SFCs. What are their objectives? Their main objective is to meet the requirement of medium and small scale industries in various states. Okay. It is similar to IFC, what we have IFCI. See, here also they have medium and large sale credit to industrial unit. The same activity is also done by the State Finance Corporation, but it is state-wise allocation, state-wise function. Okay. Now, next one is Industrial Credit and Investment Corporation of India, ICICI. See, ICICI is very familiar to you because it's now a bank, private bank, but initially it was just implemented for the industrial sectors only, but now it is available for all the other peoples also. So you can also start your savings account and all this in the ICICI bank, but their main establishment was for industrial purpose. That is why they maintain that same name in the current scenario also. So let's see. ICICI established in 1955, meaning to develop the industries under the private sector only. It is a private bank. Okay, it's a private bank, and what they do for industries, they give loans and they take deposits, all this. Okay. State Industrial Development Corporation, SIDC, established in 1960s. What is their main objective? To achieve the rapid industrialization in the state. At present, there are 28 SIDCs in India. There are 28 SIDCs in India, and what is their objective? to achieve rapid industrialization. See, these are the keywords. This is the only thing you have to understand. Others you can write in your own words. There are keywords like when you study about this industry, ICICI Bank, then you can say it is a private sector. It is a private sector bank industry. From the name itself, you can understand the feature. Then State Finance Corporation, like small and medium industries to support them. Okay, then here medium and large credit. That's it. So you can understand the keywords and write it down in the notebook. Then it is very useful for you to remember in the examination. Then next one is UTI, Unit Trust of India. You may be familiar with UTI if you are dealing with the stock market. There are this is also doing some broking services in the industry, in the SEBI. So you can get familiarized with this way if you are dealing with the stock exchange and all. What is their purpose is that? Established in 1st February 1964, what is their main objective? To encourage and mobilize the savings of the community and channelize them into productive corporate investment. See, you know that you have only small savings, like monthly you can give only 100 rupees, 20 this 200 rupees and all for the investment. It's like similar like mutual fund, but this is not a mutual fund. This is called as Unit Trust of India, UTI. Here what we do is that Unit Trust of India will collect the small savings from a small savings group, and this will be invested in a lump sum amount, as a lump sum amount, in a big industries, in a corporates. So what they are planning to achieve is that the benefit of corporates can be distributed to the small sector groups also. That's their main objective. Okay, so let us see their function. Mobilize the savings of the relatively small investors. See, relatively small investors savings are mobilized to Unit Trust through Unit Trust of India in a big corporates. Because if you directly go and try to buy shares from a big industries, it is not possible for you to get a good share or good market share, or you are not able to get the shares. But when you invest in the UTI, they will give you the return of the corporates who have already invested in those big companies. So this is the purpose. They will be collecting the small investors fund and investing in a big companies. Okay, now second one is channelize the small savings into productive investment. Yes, that's it. Then distribute the large scale economies among small income group. That's it. See, this large scale economies benefit are also given transfer to the small income group through this UTI. Okay, now Industrial Development Bank of India, this you may know, IDBI. This is also now a bank, you can see commonly in the cities, IDBI. Now 1964, established in July 1964. It's an apex bank in the industrial credit. See, we have already discussed about one apex bank, that is Central Bank, RBI. They are apex bank of all banks, apex bank in the country. Here the apex, this IDBI is an apex bank in the industrial credit. The industrial credit, industry related credits, industry related loans, this IDBI is taking initiative. They are controlling this industrial credits. Okay, it is not RBI. Up to 1976, it is a subsidiary bank to RBI. It was a subsidiary bank up to 1976, but after 1976 it was formed as autonomous corporation, but after that it has a separate existence. Okay, so see, I am underlining the years also, because in the MCQ level and match the following level you can expect this years also. Okay, so I'm not skipping those years, so you have to write it in the notebook when you are writing. Then you have to repeat it daily, 1 hour you have to use for this memory related topics. Okay, then Next, their functions of IDBI. Establish the corporation and coordination among the industrial financial institutions. See, they will be corporating and coordinating the industrial financial institutions. Those who are involved in the industrial financing, then this IDBI will be controlling them. They will be corporating and coordinating them. And it provides direct finance to industrial unit. They can directly give the finance to industrial unit, not through the bank, but also they can give directly to the industries if they approach. Okay. Saves a weaker industrial unit through development assistance fund. So there is a development assistance fund which is to revive, to get new, this recovered from the sick weaker industrial unit. Okay. The next one is assist in the creation, expansion and modernization of industrial units under private sector. Okay. They assist in creating, expanding and modernization of industrial units under private sector. Then it also provide the export finance. Also provides the export finance. Okay. See, why it's related to export? Because export, in exporting also we have industries, industries like whatever we have produced, whatever industries we have in India, we have to export it into other countries. So there is a good support required for exporting, because there is many cost involved. There's a risk of not receiving, collecting the payments, and all these are possible. So this can be financed by the IDBI. Export and Import Bank of India, that is Exim Bank, established in 1st March 1982. It's a non-bank financial intermediary, NBFI. It's a non-bank financial intermediary. It is not a banking system. They are not doing the banking activity, but it is a controlling authority for export and import activities. Okay. So they are only doing these activities. They will not do any other activities, but they will be strictly following the import and export related matters in the case of money and the banking system. Okay. Confined into the area of operation to foreign trade of India. It also performs other functions. They are confined to the area of expo operations of the foreign trade in India, and also they do other functions. It is also related to the foreign trade, that is export rediscounting. When you export, you will get some bill of exchange, you know, that rediscounting and all this. So if somebody gives a rediscounting bill, then you can get it collected from the Exim Bank. They will be supporting you. Okay. This export or rediscounting, then refinance supply credit. When you are supplying or giving for credit, or when you have to receive some fund from the outside the country, this can be refinanced. You can ask the support of the Exim Bank to get some additional loan for the supplies and all this. Okay. Then bulk import finance, foreign currency pre-shipment credit. See, pre-shipment means before the shipment, you have to give some payment to the other country if you want to import the goods, and at the same time if you are exporting also, you will need some fund before a shipment, and this fund, whatever you need, you can get the assistance from the Exim Bank. Okay. The next one is Product Equipment Finance Corporation. Okay. So that's it. Then next one is Business Advisory Technical Assistance. Business advisory, you have to do this business, you have your business is coming to lose, and you have to do this activities, you can get these loans, and all these advices, technical advices, can be given by the Exim Bank. Okay. Now, a very familiar name which you might have heard many times before, that is NABARD, National Bank Agricultural and Rural Development, established in July 1982. On the basis of recommendation of Crafi Card. Okay. Apex body in the agriculture credit. Now you see three apex. One is apex body, apex bank in the country, that is RBI. Then next one is industrial unit. Apex banks in industrial unit is IDBI. Here NABARD is apex bank for agriculture credit. Wherever the agriculture credit or agriculture related loans are to be given, it is within the control of the NABARD, not with the RBI. Okay, so that's it. The next, taking over the functions of agricultural credit, Department of RBI and Agriculture Refinance Corporation. Agriculture credit is taken over by the NABARD from the RBI and Agriculture Refinance Development Corporation. Okay, it provides all as a source of refinance to cooperatives, commercial banks, and regional rural banks. To all banks, they gives the refinancing facilities. Okay, then promoting the research in agriculture and rural development, research and development in the agriculture and rural development. See, here they are not doing just agriculture activities, they are also doing the rural development. Rural development means not just agriculture, road facilities and all these basic facilities. For that also they can give loan, not just agriculture, it is for rural development also. Okay, now next financial institution is LIC, Life Insurance Corporation of India, 1956. See, nationalizing, by nationalizing, established in 1956, by nationalizing 245 private insurance companies. So before nationalization of LIC, there was 245 private insurance companies in India. They were nationalized and they came to known as Life Insurance Corporation of India. Then primary objectives, what is your primary objectives? Nationalization was to protect interest of the policy holder and avoid the misuse of fund. That is their primary objective. What? Interest of the policy holder and avoid misuse of fund, two primary objectives. Secondly, what is their second objective? The objective of nationalization was to direct the investment of fund in the government securities, leaving a small part of private sector. See, LIC will get some fund like 100 crore. This can be invested in private sector and public sector also. Before, when it was controlled by private sector, they will invest most of the fund in a private sector. But this will not benefit the government. So government says that LIC will be investing their 87.5% is the government related security. So that only the government gets the revenue and the remaining only goes to the private sector. This is revenue related matters. LIC gives a good revenue for the government. Okay, now next point is general insurance. See, general insurance company GIC, 1973, formed in 1972. Sorry, before nationalization, a few big companies and about 100 small companies were in this business before nationalization. Okay, then at present, GST is provided for companies. They are currently, they are giving only GST is provided by four companies only. That is National Insurance Company, New India Assurance Company, Oriental Fire and General Insurance Company, United India Fire and General Insurance Company. See, you have to understand that what is General Insurance Company. See, General Insurance Company is not like Life Insurance Company and all. This is generally to protect. The main feature of GIC is to sell insurance service against some form of risk. Like, see, risk like loss of physical assets of the various kinds, like fire accident, against personal sickness and accidents. This medical insurance, this vehicle insurance, all this comes under general insurance. Generally, whatever is not considered as a life insurance, then we can say that is a general insurance. So this general insurance is also an important financial institution. These financial institutions are basically classified into four. In order to remember this four names, you just have to remember the names of insurance company with whom you can take the vehicle loan, then you can easily understand. National Insurance, New India Assurance, Oriental Insurance, United India Assurance, all this is a vehicle insurance company also. So that is also general insurance company. Securities Exchange Board of India, SEBI, set up in 1988. got statutory reorganization in 1992. See, it was established in 1988, but statutory reorganization, that is, the government has started regulating this SEBI only in 1992. Before, it was a private organization. Now, the main purpose, what is the main purpose? Regulating the business in stock market and other security market. So their main purpose is to regulate the stock market. Okay. Next one is Asian Development Bank. Whatever financial institution we have discussed as now till now is within the India, and India is the only authority who is in this management. But here now we are going to discuss about a new form of financial institution, that is Asian Development Bank. It is not an Indian organization. Okay, let us see. Established in 1966, main aim is to promote the socio and economic progress of number of, see, it is not number, it is member countries in Asia and Pacific. So in Pacific and Asia region, whatever the countries is there, in order to develop those countries, all the countries together comes, and they are considering a banking system, and it will be giving loan to these countries. Owned by government of 27 countries from region and 16 countries from outside the region. So in this Asian Development Bank, there are 37 countries within Asian and Pacific region and 16 countries outside the region. Headquarters in Manila, Philippines. Poverty reduction is a now main mission. So their current mission is poverty reduction. Okay. See, International Monetary Fund, 1947, March 1947. One of the outcome of Bretton Woods Conference. Bretton Woods Conference. Main objective. Administer of code of fair practice in the sphere of foreign exchange and to make loan to the economics experience the temporary deficit in its balance of payment. That's it. International Monetary Fund, what is their main aim? Administer a code of fair practice in the sphere of foreign exchange. In the case of foreign exchange, there should be a fair practice, and to make loan to the economic experiencing temporary difficulty in their balance of trade. Those countries who are in this IMF, or who are considering this IMF as a financial institution, they can collect loans from this institute for their temporary deficit. Okay. So what they do, these are International Monetary Fund, what are their functions? Let us see. Quotas. It is a membership contribution fixed in terms of its national income, and the internal trade members are required to subscribe quota partly in gold and partly in domestic currency. Okay, this is like whatever the national income that a country is having, they should have a combination of 25% of gold in the national income and a domestic currency 75%. That's it. So that is a requirement of IMF in case of quota. This is gold 25:75, 2.5:7.5 ratio. Now exchange rate. The members of IMF has declared the par value of national currency in terms of gold or American dollar. Okay, so all the members of IMF shall be giving the declaration of the par value, the currency value, in terms of gold and American dollar. So this is what the IMF country should do. These two are the two important things that is to be the function of IMF. Then next one is special drawing rights. See, you have to understand one thing. This is the 13th point, International Monetary Fund, these quotas and exchange rate and special drawing right SDRs are the sub points in the IMF. Okay, now let us see special drawing rights. What is special drawing right? Introduced in 1969, it is a special currency issued by IMF. So it is a currency issued by IMF. Like every country issues their own currency, IMF is issuing currency. That currency is known as special drawing right, SDR, for two reasons. Why? What are the two reasons why IMF creates SDR? First thing is to overcome the shortage of gold in the world economy. See, we have already said that some countries have to maintain 25% as a gold and 75% as a their own domestic currency, but it is not possible. Gold may not be available with them, but instead of this gold, they can use this special drawing right as an alternative for gold. So to overcome the shortage of gold in the world economy, to avoid the movement of gold across national boundaries. See, if you are giving the loan, the repayment in gold to other countries, your gold reserve will be lost. So instead of giving the gold, you can give the special drawing rights. So you will not lose a gold available gold deposit in your country. Instead, you give an equivalent amount of special drawing rights. This will not eliminate your gold movement. This will not give make any movement of gold from one country to another. So this is a good approach of IMF. Next one. Now SDRs are in coupon. It is used in place of gold, hence it is called paper gold. It is called paper gold. Okay, now 14th financial institution, that is World Bank, established in 1947, one of the outcome of Bretton Woods conference, same as IMF. IMF is also an outcome of Bretton Woods conference. Okay, Bretton Woods conference. So the same way, World Bank is also an outcome of Bretton Woods conference. Now, what are the aim? Main aim of the establishment of World Bank is to help reconstruction of member countries' damages due to the Second World War. So the Bretton Woods conference was after the Second World War, and the main aim of them was to help the countries who have already affected with the Second World War situation. So in order to help them, they have started a new banking system, that is World Bank. The original name of the World Bank is International Bank for Reconstruction and Development, IBRD. That is the original name for World Bank. It's a good general knowledge for you. Okay, now the last financial institution that we are discussing in this chapter is International Development Association, established in 1960, is affiliated to World Bank. Okay, it's affiliated to World Bank. That means affiliated means within the control of World Bank. It is a separate organization but having a control from the World Bank. Okay, meaning to provide assistance to low developed countries where per capita income is less than $520 in 1975. In 1975, to $520 per capita, if less than $520 per capita income, then those are eligible for loan from the IDA. Okay, so they're to provide assistance, that is their main aim, and also grants a credit on cheap terms compared to World Bank loan. So it is cheaper than the IDA, is cheaper than the World Bank loans. So these are the financial institutions that we are that we have discussed in this chapter. So thank you, friends. Thanks for watching. Please like, support and share my channel. This is our second last video on CMA economics lecture. So with the next video, we'll be concluding our CMA economics topic. Any doubts in this subject, you can ask me through the comment. I will be replying to you, or you can give the question in my WhatsApp group that I have given in the description. So whatever way you can communicate with me, I will be responding to you in a best manner. Thank you. Thanks for watching.